Working with files and especially saving files can be a hassle, especially across platforms, but not anymore for .NET MAUI. In this video, we're going to learn how to save files the easy way. Mobile devices and cross-platform apps and file systems, you know, it can be a hassle. If you have some experience with it, you probably know what I'm talking about. And especially with saving files, right? You have to have the user pick a location, what type of file, actually save the file. Now with .NET MAUI and the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, we've made that super, super easy. We now have the File Saver API, which allows you to do all of this basically in one operation. The user can pick a location, save the file, the contents that you have prepared from your application, it will be saved and you get the path as a return value. So basically, what other thing can I do to just hop over to Visual Studio and show you how to work with it? Welcome to Visual Studio 2022. I just created a new .NET MAUI application, and as always, you can find all the code in a GitHub repository that is on my account. So find the link down below or just search for my user on GitHub and you'll probably find it. So this is just a final new thing. The thing that I already did is install the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So if I go over to my Solution Explorer, you know how to do it, right? You right click on your project, manage NuGet packages. I already installed the Community Toolkit.MAUI. You can see it right here, and you will need to do a little bit of initialization here with the use MAUI Community Toolkit. You've watched all my other videos, so you know how to do this, right? And you need to have the using Community Toolkit.MAUI for that right here. So actually, for this one, let's do it the proper way, and we can use dependency injection, right? So what we're going to do is say builder.services.add. I can do this as a singleton, I guess. So add singleton, and I can say I file saver. You can see it, here it is. It lives in community toolkit.maui.storage. And the one I want to register is file saver.default, right? So this kind of follows the other APIs that we have in .NET MAUI, where you have the default static implementation of the file picker or the media picker and a bunch of other things. Geolocation, they all have this kind of pattern, so you can register it like this. So we got that set up, and we need to have the builder.services.add transient for my main page, so I can use this with the constructor injection, right? So now it has all this, it knows about all my dependencies. I can go over to my main page.xaml.cs, and in my main page, I can now here say I file saver, file saver, and I'll put that in a little field. I'm not going to use this count, so let's just replace this with I file saver. Naming is hard, so I'm not even going to try. And then I have to say this dot file saver is file saver, and Visual Studio already knows what's up, so it helps me with the IntelliSense right here. So now I got this file saver that will be injected through dependency injection, and I can use this to actually save my file. So let's do that in this counter click thing right here. And what I want to do is, well, let's first explore what is here. And it's actually just one thing. We just have the save async, but there's a lot of power packed into this. So what you can do here is set an initial path. So for an initial path, which is going to suggest the user like, hey, this might be a good spot to save your file. I know this is not a thing that is supported across all the platforms, so make sure to check the documentation for any of this, because I know for Windows, for instance, the initial path, you can't set that to something custom, so it's probably not going to work perfectly there. But it is there for you to configure if you want to use it. Then we have the file name, so the file name that you kind of want to suggest, because there's still going to have this dialogue and put in their file name, right? And you can use the stream for the contents that you're going to put in there, the file contents. And then you have a cancellation token. And with a cancellation token, you can cancel this operation from your application, right? So maybe you have some kind of timeout, a timer in your application. If they're not going to save within 10 seconds, then everything will detonate and you're going to cancel this operation. You can say cancellation token.cancel, and it will programmatically cancel the dialogue and not continue any further. Not going to focus on that. If that's something that you want to learn more on, let me know down in the comments below. So this is also, it has a couple of overloads to make this kind of like simpler and more verbose. So what I want to do first is probably come up with some contents that I actually want to go save, right? So what I want to do here is probably come up with a stream. So I'm going to do a using because you have to clean up the streams. And I'm going to say var stream is new, and I'm just going to do a memory stream. So this is a thing that's going to be in memory. And then I can say encoding. So I'm just going to do a simple string, not the Android encoding. We have multiple encodings now. Welcome to cross-platform development. I just want to have the system.txt. So encoding.default.getBytes, because I want to get the bytes from this. And I can just put a string in here. So maybe something like, I don't know, have you subscribed to this amazing channel yet? I don't know, maybe you're watching some YouTube channel and you think like, ooh, you suddenly feel the urge to click the subscribe button. This is your cue. So now I have a simple string, but this of course can be an image, it can be binary, it can be whatever you want to write in that file. I'm just gonna go with a simple text. So I can use this now, and now I can say, var path is, because this is going to save it, right? And this is going to return me, I actually didn't show you that, but this is going to return a string, which is the file path where it actually ended up saving this this thing. So I want to make this async so that everything is happy here. And I can say for the file path is subscribe.txt, and then I want to do the stream, which is going to be stream. And I'm not going to really use the cancellation token here. Else, what I could do, I could probably still show you, is cancellation token source, cancellation token source, and I can is new, so I can create a new one here. And then I can put this cancellation token source in here, dot token. Which is the actual, oh, is it not a token? Is it a token? And now if I would want to cancel, I could say, cancellation token source dot cancel, right? So I could cancel it, and then the dialogue would probably disappear and all magic things would happen. So you could do this, or if you don't want to use this functionality, you could just say default here, and that will do basically this new cancellation token inside of this thing, but you can't reach it, so you're never going to use it, right? So I'll just use it for, leave it for this, so that it will end up in the GitHub repository like this as well, so that you know how to work with this if that's what you want. And then let's go over to my XAML actually for a little bit. So I'm going to reuse this Hello World label just because it has a nice big font. And I'm going to say name, and I'm going to say file saver results, something like that. And I can use this to actually put in the path here, right? So we can inspect what's going on here. So I can set this text to path. And we have that. Well, no, it's going to be, oh, I forgot the await here, so that's why it's not working. Okay, so now what is going to happen, actually just run it on Windows, it's going to create the stream, it's going to give me a little dialogue, save async, so it's going to suggest me subscribe.txt, which is probably fine, it's going to put the stream in there, and it's going to give me back the resulting file path. So if I click here, I expect to see a little dialogue here, it already suggests me here, subscribe.txt. I can go here to, I don't know, desktop, like and subscribe. That sounds like something. So subscribe.txt, save it there. And you can see this resulting path here in the UI, right? So see users, my username, desktop, like and subscribe, subscribe.txt. And whenever I pull up a little Explorer window now here and go to my desktop to like and subscribe, you can see this subscribe.txt. And whenever I open it, it has written this contents that I've put in here. Have you subscribed to this amazing channel yet? So if you haven't the last time, then do it now. So this is how you can easily save files in your .NET MAUI application. If you have been dealing with these types of scenarios before, then you probably know that this is a great improvement, because this is just 1, 2, 3 lines of code, depending on how you count this, to save a file, to save these contents on a custom location. Whereas if you had to do this before, you had to write code to show the dialogue, actually get the bytes for your file, let the user pick a location, write the a lot of hassle. Now, one line of code in the .NET Maven Community Toolkit, and boom, you're done. There's a couple of important things that I didn't show you. One is you want to wrap this in a try-catch block. I will make sure that is in the code that ends up in the GitHub repository below, because if you cancel out of the dialog, then it will throw a exception. So you want to make sure that you know your application does not have an unhandled exception suddenly. So use this for your validation scenarios to check if the user actually saved something or canceled out of it. The other thing I didn't show you is the permissions. For Windows, you don't need to set up any additional permissions, but for Android and Tizen, I think you definitely do, which is all described in the documentation. So make sure to check the documentation in the link down in the video description below. That is all I have right now. Do you see any room for improvements here? Do you like this? Do you not like this? Please let me know down in the comments or on the repository for the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit so we can improve and make things better for you. Otherwise, until then, please click the like button on this video so all the people can learn about the amazing file saver that we have right here. I would very much appreciate that. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't picked up on the hints in this video earlier. And before you go, maybe you want to also, you know, pick a folder, which is also something amazing that's in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. Check the video for that right here, or check out this full playlist with amazing .NET MAUI Community Toolkit videos on this side. And I'll be seeing you for the next video.